Oye, la última vez que los vi estaban un poquito más chaparritos. ¿Qué pasó? Que comieron mucha espinaca, crecieron de más. ¿La qué? Wait, what did you say, Chris?
Los tenis.
Ah. There it is. Oh, tú dijiste la bota.
La bota.
Ay, yo escuché otra cosa. Like, wow. Ya estamos llegando a abril, but hold on. So we got Chris, we got Eric, we got Richard, we got Zadiel, we got Joel in the studio y una nueva canción que están promoviendo. And I love it because this song is in Spanish.
So when we got the song, it's a throwback. It's like a, it's
right.
A
rhythm,
a sample,
of, the
rhythm
yeah.
of the night, yeah, by the Barge. So we, as soon as we heard it, we just felt good. You know, it just felt like a good song. It threw us back to our moms or our aunts cleaning the house. You know what I mean? So it was like that kind of vibe. And as soon as we recorded it, we recorded it first in English, and then we were like, "Yo, we're missing our Spanish roots. You know, we're missing like where we come from. You know." So we included it, and it became amazing. We fell in love with the song, so we had to release it to see what people were thinking. By now they're like liking it, so it's yeah. like 32.
You think? You think?
So,
no,
yeah,
sí.
So it's cool.
Cuando yo escuché la canción por la primera vez, o sea, yo no sabía que tenía el sample, right? So yo la escuché, I was like, hold on, and I had to like really dig into my head because you know it's been a while since the song came out. I mean, how many of you were born when the song came out?
Yo no.
Right? No, pero como dijo Richard, o sea, te regresas a cuando lo tocaba tu mamá, tus tías, you know. But you said cleaning the house.
Yeah.
How did your mom get down when she cleaned the house? Because if she was there. Bailando con la escoba. So when you guys talk about this song, Pretend. Why was there a motivation that you guys felt like this song hits home with us? ¿A quién le tocó más el tema?
I've had that kind of experience, but let's say we felt that people could relate, you know what I mean?
Okay.
Like, not everybody, but some people could relate, or they could get into that character. It's just a fun song, you know. This song is more about the guy, like they're both taken, but at night they only think about each other, you know, so they really want to be with each other. So it's more about, like, you know, they when it comes to night, they really want to, like, you know, hook up or whatever it is.
Mm-hmm.
So it just felt like people could relate. It felt like people could get into that character, have fun with it, and dance, and, you know, and yeah, it just felt good. So we just threw it out like that.
Y cuando mencionaste que, you know, your roots, I know you guys are from all different parts of Latin America. Chris, ¿tú eres de dónde?
Ecuador.
Cuba.
República Dominicana.
México.
Y Puerto Rico.
See, everybody's from different places. Jeez. Por ejemplo, no les da por hacer, no les ha entrado porque, pues, bueno, o sea, de Puerto Rico le han entrado un poquito al reggaetón. Pero how about, like, por ejemplo, bachata or, you know, regional? Like, have you guys thought about doing collaborations that way?
Pues sí, la verdad que sí, estamos abiertos a hacer cualquier tipo de género. De hecho, en nuestro primer álbum tenemos diferentes tipos de género, no solamente reggaetón, tenemos
urbano,
balada, un poco de merengue,
un poco de rock.
Tenemos muchísimas cosas. Ah, hicimos banda.
¿A poco?
También, sí, con Joe Favela.
En unos premios.
Estamos, la verdad, abiertos a hacer cualquier tipo de género.
¿Qué es lo que viene para Ciencio? O sea, después, I know Pretend has like millions of views already por YouTube. Yo sé que tiene mucho por crecer, pero ustedes, ¿qué es lo que ustedes ven en el futuro para Ciencio?
Yo creo que, nada, seguir haciendo mucha música, seguir creciendo como compositores, artistas, y tenemos como un sueño que todavía no se nos da, pero es lo que queremos de hace ya bastante tiempo. Y es como a una película o un documental o algo.
También los vi que están involucrados con video. ¿Todos tienen perritos aquí, mascotas?
No, sí, yo no tengo, pero quisiera.
¿Sí? ¿Qué perrito? ¿Cuando tú vas a adoptar perrito?
Sí, estaría súper brutal. Pero no sé, quisiera encontrar el momento perfecto para hacerlo, poder cuidarlo bien y eso.
Ah, porque ahorita andan por las partes.
Sí.
¿Cómo se llama tu perrito, Chris?
Mi perrito se llama Toby.
Toby?
Toby. He's un chiquito, un French poodle mixed with a schnauzer.
Eric, you have one?
I used to have one, but he's not anymore.
But I love him.
Yo tengo una en DR, his name is Rocky.
Rocky?
Yeah, he's what's it called?
Rottweiler.
Wow.
Doberman.
French poodle.
Chihuahua.
You have one, Joel?
Yeah, I have three of them.
You have them in Mexico, you have them here?
No, I have them in my house, like an hour and a half from here.
I was like, over here. Right, porque tú vives aquí, ¿no? En Los Ángeles.
Yeah.
Everybody lives here in LA?
No.
Oh, wow. So then how do you guys, o sea,
whenever home. So, yeah, that's basically what.
We basically live together, like, you know.
The hotel.
On the road. And,
yeah.
Whenever home, so.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, yeah, la última vez que hablé con ustedes, dijeron que había momentos donde no se aguantaban, ahora ya es un poquito mejor.
Claro, claro.
¿Quién ronca?
Yo creo que aquí toditos tenemos otro día que roncamos, Ivana.
Sí, ¿no? Cuando uno está súper cansado.
Sí, yo me meto.
¿Qué es lo que más extrañan de casa ya que
la comida?
La comida,
la familia.
Los
perros,
la cama,
la comida,
los amigos, la tranquilidad donde vivo.
Bueno, CNCO, thank you so much for stopping by. Ya sé que andan muy ocupados y que les da por ir a comer Mexican food. So, thank you so much, guys.
Thank
and
you.
Pretend is out. Make sure to keep requesting it and check out 24 Horas, the new remix that hit out today with CNCO.
Yeah.
And in theater soon.
Yeah.